Cheryl come and request to get approval for their product, the tax plan, they conducted a study on animals, and said there are some animals, low-dose, low-dose, high-dose, product, and then they use control animals that supposedly have any of the product. When they submitted this to the FDA, and the FDA looked at it, there was some question about the study. One of the scientists, neuroscientists, looked at some of this. Saw a lot of red flags, and there's some real questions here about tumors being caused with this product, particularly brain tumors. So they ordered a study to be done by the Bureau of Foods, which was a precursor to that. And Dr. Jerome Bressler was in charge of this group to look through this, the research that had been done by Sarah, and that's what the Bressler report about. And this is the report here. Basically, what it shows is that either a lot of purposeful shenanigans was carried on to get this product approved, or, as he states it, it was the world's worst research. They found that what they did is the animals that died after being fed nutritionally, they didn't autopsy the animals right away. Some of them were not autopsied more than a year after. And of course, the tissue broke down and liquefied, and so they couldn't do proper studies on them, but they reported it as if they had. They reported these as normal. They found that they were taking tumors and cutting them out and throwing them away and saying the animal was normal. They had animal tissues that had obvious tumors in it. They had, in one of the cases here, it was reported a lymph node that was enlarged. And this GD serial pathologist reported it as a normal lymph node. When the scientists from the Bureau of Foods looked at it,
when we did our double-blind study here at this hospital, when we had a tragic situation, which I attribute to drug abuse, we needed volunteers. We looked at both patients and people who had history of the disorder, the needs of control, so those people without. One of the people that I used in this study was the administrator, a PhD psychologist. And several days into this study, he had an emergency, an ophthalmologic emergency. He had sudden bleeding in his eye, attachment of the retina. He rushed to the Cleveland emergency surgery, but I could not say, lost the vision. At the same time, we had another participant in the study of medicine who also had an episode of intraocular bleeding to the eye. So we had two people who, during the course of the study, had eye emergencies.
Well, like cytotoxin, basically what it does is a normal transmitter in the brain. These are chemicals that allow brain cells to do anything. But if it's in even a minute over concentration of the brain, it causes the brain cells to become extremely excited. They become so excited that they're very quickly burn themselves out and die. So we see people have difficulty thinking. They feel like they're walking around in a cloud or a fog. Because the brain cells become extremely excited. They become so excited.